Use this play to expose your opponent for big yardage down the middle of the field. Coming up next. Full Game Prometheus, the only YouTuber that shows you full games of all the tips and schemes I post on my channel. I'll show you the good, the bad, and the ugly. All right, so guys, new to my channel, make sure you subscribe button, also that notification icon so you can never miss an upload. So I'm actually doing a couple of formation breakdowns for one of my patrons, and I actually just jumped into this formation for the hell of it. It wasn't something he requested, but I just took a gander at it, and it's the I-form H slot open. Now, I think this might be part of the live NFL playbooks because I couldn't find this on maddenfocus.com, but I want to show you this particular play, which is going to be the play action draw shot. This play is very glitchy. The slot route, which is kind of a deep post, is very glitchy and allows you to attack your opponent deep over the middle of the field against the majority of the coverages. There's one coverage you will lock up the way I'm going to set this up, but if you do have a guy that runs the other type of coverage, you can quickly make one minor adjustment, and then it's going to open it up for one play touchdowns for you. Now, what's great about this formation too is that it comes with a lead draw, which is kind of a glitchy run. It's a draw play, but you actually have an extra blocker that's actually going to block for you. So this is a play that you really don't find in a lot of playbooks, so it's good to be able to incorporate that. So that's going to be one of the hot audibles, and I'll show you how that works too and how you can use it in conjunction against your opponent. So let's go ahead and take a look at this half, the play action draw shot play, where it's a double post off to the right hand side. You got kind of an angle route off the right, and then you got a fast release and one of the quick adjustments that we do. So if you got a guy that runs a lot of heavy man blitzes, we're going to go ahead and block our running back to give us a little additional time. And then the basic setup that we're always going to do is we're going to drag up our outside receiver more on the right-hand side. Now, our first read, our key read, is going to be Lockett. This is the guy that's going to get past a lot of coverages. And we're going to throw the ball as soon as he makes his break. We'll do a nice little inside pass lead. And what's going to happen is he should be able to get underneath that man blitz coverage for you. You can go ahead and leave the fullback in his block and release. So it'll give you another person to block. And obviously you can check it down underneath right here is another's area of the field, but it's really opening up that deep route. So we're just gonna go ahead and drag up more. And we're gonna watch that one route. And this is the route that's actually going to get really good. So it's important that you put your best wide receiver in that slot position. So we're going to go ahead and drag up more. I'm going to block my my fullback to give us a little bit more time. But watch what happens with this route. There's really nobody in the area, and you actually can get an easy, 20-yard gainer right there. Now you could drag up your odd receiver and also leave that block and release, and that gives you another area of the field you could check down to with the block and release, because you know he's going to go up the line and then he's going to come out. Now I'm going to go in against a bunch of random cover fours, but let's just go ahead and watch how this play works. And once again, we got an opportunity where we can get a huge play. So if he goes into cover four with matching principles, so you can get some big yardage. Now obviously you've got the underneath routes, but you've also got this route too. If you got a bad cover, that corner over there on the left-hand side is really not one of the better corners, but you can actually go and hit that too. So what locks this play up consistently is actually cover two, and that's going to actually go ahead. I'll show you how that works against this, the way this is set up. If you go ahead and put a cover two coverage, the mid-read actually plays this route perfectly, and that's going to put a defender in the area to make a play. So if you got a guy that's running this play against you, you just simply jump into cover two, and just that quick, you've actually locked this play up. As you can see, that mid-read is going to get in the area of that play and actually go ahead and just take it away. He's going to get in that passing lane. But what I discovered is to go ahead and expose cover two, I played around with different plays, but I discovered you could stay in this play, but now your drag route is going to be your slot receiver. You're going to leave that deep post on more as your next play. So now watch what happens. The defender actually pulls out, and it's going to give me a passing lane right in the middle of the field that I actually can go and get to. So that's what's cool about this particular play, is that you can pretty much run this against any kind of coverage. If a guy's showing you a lot of the same coverage, you just drag, and he's doing cover two, you're going to go ahead and drag a blocket. If he's using any other coverage like cover three or cover four, you basically go and do the original setup that are showing you. So watch this. Watch how this guy doesn't actually get played. And obviously, if you got the speed, you can take that for a touchdown in that type of situation. Now, what another thing too with this particular play is that you can go ahead and use the following audible. One of the audibles I wanted to use is the lead draw, and it feeds off of this particular play. So watch this. We're going to go ahead and just run this against random coverages. And if you do zone coverages, the defenders are all going to drop back, and this is going to give you huge play opportunities where you can just go ahead and down the middle of the field with this run play. So this is what really opens up this play a lot, is that you're still kind of showing the same look, but now you've got basically an inside draw play. I love a lead draw. It's not a very popular run in the game. Very, very effective against basically anybody that runs a lot of zone coverages. And a lot of times what's going to happen is that you're going to get more positive yards than you would get negative against guys that run a lot of zone coverages. And all you have to do is just follow your blocks. So some block sheds right there against a porous line of the Seahawks. But I assure you that if you've got guys that actually can block for you, you're going to get some pretty good opportunities for you with that, with a good run play. So once again, to my subscribers, thank you for support. If you do like these type of tips, go ahead and smash that like button, and I'll be rolling out more offensive and defensive tips to take your game to the next level. So once again, thank you for support, and until next time.